Hello, I am Kobayashi from Sony. In this video, we will discuss transfer learning, a method of reusing models trained with large amounts of data to perform a training process using small amounts of data and still achieve a high level of accuracy. The content in this video is aimed at those with basic knowledge of deep learning. Please view our previous videos covering the basics of deep learning if you would like to learn or review that content. First, let's go over exactly what transfer learning in deep learning is. As mentioned just before, we have a training challenge with a different objective than that of neural networks trained with large amounts of data. For example, reusing an image classification neural network trained using more than 1 million images for another image classification task, semantic segmentation, object recognition, or some other image-related application. This enables us to train the new application with a small amount of data and still achieve a high level of performance. With deep learning, we can achieve an extremely high level of recognition performance by training a neural network with a large amount of data. Practically speaking, it is often difficult to collect a large amount of data quickly enough when tackling a completely new task. However, obtaining sufficient performance using only a small amount of data for training is also difficult. In these situations, we can use transfer learning to reuse neural networks trained with a large amount of data. By applying transfer learning to a new task, you can possibly achieve significantly higher performance in comparison to training with only a small amount of data, even with datasets as small as a few dozen or hundred data samples. Now let's take a look at how to perform the transfer learning process with neural networks. When normally training neural networks without using transfer learning, random numbers are used as the initial values for neuron weights. The weights of neurons initialized with random numbers are then slowly updated during the training process performed using training datasets. In this scenario, training using a small amount of data results in not being able to sufficiently adjust neuron weights and thus insufficient performance. To perform the transfer learning process, we should prepare a neural network model trained with a large amount of data that can handle the same type of input data, which becomes the source model for transfer learning. If working with images, for example, we need a source neural network configured to process images. In some cases, we can reuse everything but the final layer or the first half of this neural network. The second half of the neural network, or sometimes just the final layer, is configured to solve the actual task. If, for example, we reuse convolutional neural network trained to classify 1,000 different images for another image-related task, the source CNN will have 1,000 output neurons. To apply this to a two-class image classification problem, the final layer will have 2 neurons. To apply this to a semantic segmentation application, we will keep only the convolution layer and add the latter part of the convolution layer. With transfer learning, we train the neural network with a dataset using the neural network already trained with weight parameters in these first half layers as initial values. One training method involves updating only weight parameters for the second half or final layer. Another fine-tuning method using the learning rate and mini-batch gradient descent method to reduce hyperparameters that determine the size of update parameters. Then all neural network weight parameters, including the reuse part, are updated. The number of weight parameters updated by the training process when training only the final layer is limited only to the parameters related to the new portion of the neural network. The advantage of this is an extremely fast training process. As the training process is complete in nearly an instant, this is an effective method when you want to train a neural network with new data instantly. The fine-tuning method in which the entire network is trained can achieve higher performance than the method of only training the final layer. Because all network parameters are updated, the amount of computation needed for training is significantly higher. Okay, let's actually perform the transfer learning process. Here, we have a total of 320 images consisting of 160 images of flowers and 160 images of food. We will train an image classification system to classify these images into flower and food images. Here, we will use the ResNext 101 network to perform a 5,000 epoch training process and then process 80 validation data. The right vertical axis in the graph represents the error rate. As you can see, we were able to obtain an average classification accuracy of 95% with a maximum accuracy of 97.5%. Now we will reuse ResNext 101, which was trained with 1.28 million images in the ImageNet 1K dataset. Changing the final layer with two categories of flower and food, we will train this layer by fine-tuning all parameters including reuse ones. Although it is a simple task to classify input images as flowers or food with a 100 epoch training process, we achieved an accuracy rate of 98.8% to 100%, which is significantly higher than the performance of a neural network not trained using transfer learning. The horizontal axis of the previous graph represented 5,000 epochs. Here we have 100 epochs, which shows that we obtained nearly 100% accuracy quite early in the training process. Successful utilization of transfer learning requires data used for training from the pre-trained model used as a source be similar to the data needed to train the new neural network to solve some new task. This is also true, for example, with humans. A person can fully utilize their previous experience if they transfer to a new job that is nearly the same as their old job. If a person enters a completely new industry, that person will have to learn the new job completely from scratch. In the same way, we could have a pattern in which we reuse a model trained to classify natural images such as landscapes and people to create a model that classifies different landscapes. We can expect transfer learning to produce a suitable result in this case. If we try to reuse this model to segment geometric patterns that are quite different from natural images, though, the final result might not be very useful. Having said that, using transfer learning in such circumstances can sometimes produce suitable results. As such, using transfer learning is worth a try when you cannot achieve suitable performance from a limited amount of data. Also, as I have said many times in past videos, the best way to achieve the best performance with deep learning is to collect large amount of high-quality data. Even if transfer learning is used to obtain a relatively high level of accuracy, it would still be better to collect a large amount of data relevant to the specific task if you can, because that will result in the best possible performance. Transfer learning is a very effective technique to use when it is necessary to obtain high precision with as short of development period and minimal effort as possible. Using transfer learning in the training process achieves high performance from a small amount of data. However, because the quantity and the quality of the data used for training the source model determine performance, the source model must have been trained using a large amount of high-quality data. This training is typically a fairly large-scale effort. Models trained using a large amount of data are sometimes made available on the internet. You might be able to find models suitable for use in typical applications such as image processing. Many image classification and natural language processing models have been made available particularly for research and development applications. Note that some available models and datasets used to train these models cannot be used for commercial use. You must observe any applicable license and other usage rights when using such resources. Many image processing pre-trained models using the neural network libraries, Sony's deep learning framework used in Neural Network Console, are available for download. If you would like to use these resources, access the link in the video description to access some trained models. In this video, I have introduced the technique of transfer learning used in deep learning. One criticism of deep learning is that humans can recognize objects with just a glance, while deep learning requires a lot of data and calculation for the training process. However, we can also use the transfer learning technique to achieve a high level of deep learning performance despite a short training process using very little data. From birth, human beings develop their ability to identify objects visually from large amounts of visual information as we constantly are observing the world around us as we mature. It could be said that we are able to recognize objects with just a glance because of the development of this ability from the time we are born. The transfer learning technique in deep learning is a process of taking a model which is somewhat compares to the human sense of vision and has been trained with a large amount of data and reusing it to achieve suitable performance with a small amount of new data. If you cannot harness the power of deep learning because you cannot prepare enough data, you might be able to use transfer learning with neural networks trained with a large amount of data to process similar input data. Other techniques besides transfer learning to achieve suitable performance with little data for training are also available to us. Transfer learning can also be used for other purposes than that discussed in this video. I would like to present more videos in the future covering these techniques. In future videos, I would also like to discuss the use of transfer learning in Neural Network Console, our deep learning integrated development environment, as well as the process to load pre-trained models and train only the last layer and fine-tune entire networks.